Hey everyone, it's OSK. Today I wanted to talk about some Spellbreak news we got about Chapter 2, and I'm also going to go in depth with how these new leagues are going to work, because I had the chance to do some math, and it's shaping up to be quite the grind. So that's what we're going to talk about today. By the way, in case you were wondering, Chapter 2 was revealed to release in 2 weeks on Thursday, April 8th, so if that's what you want to hear, there you go. But I'm also going to go over some stuff I saw in the trailer and also some news articles that have covered the release of Chapter 2 and some new features we haven't heard about. So if you like what you hear, feel free to drop a like on the video and subscribe for some more content. And now that that's out of the way, let's get into this. So first, we're going to go over the trailer. The big takeaways other than the release date reveal and the decent animation were some little Easter eggs I saw here and there. The first of these is the fact that Avira Emberdane, the leader of the Vowbreakers, has two wind gauntlets equipped, so this could either be an Easter egg towards an old version of Spellbreak where you were able to double up on gauntlets, or it could be a reveal in plain sight that this is a feature coming to the game yet again, so keep an eye out for that. The second Easter egg we see is this sparring match with a colloquially named Jasmine character, shooting a light green colored magic. This isn't anything like what we've seen before in the game, so I'm thinking it could be a change to the color of the noodle, or it could be a hint at something brand new, like new kinds of magic. It could also be nothing, which is what I really think it is, so maybe don't pay too much attention to it, but I still wanted to point it out. And the last Easter egg I wanted to point out was this lovely hunk of man for the Valguard. If you're ever wondering what Malding looks like, here's your example. Just thought it was kind of funny. All joking aside though, Proletariat seems to be going for a more foreboding theme with this chapter, and there's a little theory I have about the Valguard causing the fracture to destroy the Vowbreaker's homeland, but I'm not that big on the lore, it's just a theory. So there you go for the trailer. It's really just three or four little tidbits I thought I'd point out. Now on to some articles. The two biggest ones I could find were from PC Invasion and Windows Central, both of which I've never heard of before, but they had some good info to share. From PC Invasion, in addition to what we already know about the chapter, we got some info on how Dominion is going to be catered towards all playstyles out there. The author claims that there's a lot of differing terrain on the maps of the Dominion mode, which would suit all classes. There are long sightlines for Conduits and Frostborn, the small capture zones make for some decent brawling for Stone Shapers and Toxicologists, Tempests have that superior roaming ability across the map, and Pyromancers kind of have a jack-of-all-trades going for them. Right now, it's looking like Frostborns, Conduits, and Stone Shapers might dominate the meta based on what we know so far, but there's still room for balance changes to hit every class in a meaningful way. You can be sure that I'll cover the meta when the time comes. Probably the biggest news out of this article from PC Invasion is their comments on outfits with progression. You may have caught a video I made criticizing this very topic, and I still do think it's not the best business practice, but I'm here to tell you that outfits with progression are coming in Chapter 2. Those elemental-based outfits that have been the subject of such controversy may finally be receiving their epic and legendary outfit upgrades during Chapter 2, so be on the lookout for that. From Windows Central, we have a bit more technical news that'll help us out for the League section I have in the last part of this video. The main takeaways from this article will be the timer set for Dominion. This timer is set for 15 minutes maximum, but the author made it a point to say that 15 minutes felt like far longer than what was needed for a typical match to finish naturally. So we may be looking at ideal match times around 10 to 12 minutes when Dominion is available to play in Spellbreak Chapter 2. The Chapter 2 pass will be costing 1,000 gold or $10, just like Chapter 1, so that's also good news. Make sure you're earning enough gold for that. The last bit of info we got about League specifically is the cost of crowns that will be needed for each match of Dominion you decide to play in each tier. As this graphic shows, bronze and silver don't cost any crowns, but gold costs 250, platinum costs 750, diamonds cost 1250, and legend will cost 1500. Legend and Diamond seem to be really steep costs, which will make grinding through those ranks really time-consuming, and honestly, it's kind of a good thing. The game has always needed something for players to grind for, and this sense of progression could have a net positive effect overall for Spellbreak, so while I do have criticism for Leagues not being a true competitive mode, we at least have something to grind for. We finally have our imaginary internet points that I'm always talking about. That's going to conclude the new info we got from news articles today, but we also got these cool screenshots. I'll flash them on the screen while I get into the next section. Alright, now we're going to get a bit serious. Now that we have some concrete values on how many crowns each tier of leagues is going to cost, we can do some math. Keep in mind, I only have a solid idea of the total amount of crowns needed to progress through bronze, silver, and gold, so platinum, diamond, and legend will be pure speculation. I will still provide a range of values for those final three ranks based on what I think would be expected for them, though. Alright, so the main calculations I want to make is how many games it will take to progress through each league and how long that will take. We know that Chapter 2, and every chapter for that matter, is based on a 12-week length of time, so we will use that for calculations later. Alright, so first we need to figure out how much XP is needed for each league rank. Thankfully, between some information we have from League's Reddit post and a few dev replies and a bit of math, we know for sure that the maximum crowns needed for bronze, silver, and gold based on the images given to us. Keep in mind that these values are technically still subject to change since the chapter isn't out yet, so you have been warned. Based on our info, we know that from tier 10 of bronze to tier 9 is 1500 crowns, and we know that tier 1 of bronze to tier 10 of silver is 15,000 crowns. Based on this and some other trends I've seen from other screenshots, we know that each tier of bronze increases the number of crowns needed by 1500 crowns. This means that bronze 10 needs 1500, bronze 9 needs 3000, bronze 8 needs another 4500, and so on. With this math, it's actually pretty easy. The total amount of crowns needed for each tier is exactly 55 multiplied by the crowns needed from tier 10 to tier 9, meaning getting through all of bronze is 1500 times 55, which is 82,500 crowns. We can do this for silver and gold as well. We know silver starts at 3,000 crowns for tier 10, so 3,000 times 55 is 165,000 total crowns to climb through silver. For gold, tier 10 is 7,000 crowns, so 7,000 times 55 is 385,000 total crowns to climb through gold and into platinum. Based on the info we have from this trend, it's difficult to tell if leagues are going to progress by doubling the crowns needed for tier 10 of a rank and extrapolating from there, or if it's a different incremental increase, so this is where the ranges will kick in. Please take the values for Platinum, Diamond, and Legend with a heavy grain of salt, like the biggest grain of salt that you can think of. I'm going to assume a range of 12,000 to 15,000 crowns needed for Tier 10 of Platinum, 18,000 to 30,000 for Diamond, and 25,000 to 50,000 for Legend. I'm picking nice round numbers because it seems like this is what Proletariat will go for. We all like nice round numbers. This will give crown totals of anywhere from 660,000 to 825,000 for platinum, 990,000 to 1,650,000 for diamond, and 1,375,000 to 2,750,000 for legend. They're wide ranges, I know, but I'm trying to give you the shortest ideal games compared to the longest as best as I can here. Now, Jesse had replied to a comment from Megaverse on Reddit about how many crowns one would normally earn in a match. Jesse speculated that 1,500 crowns would be considered an average match, 650 would be bad, and 2,500 would be considered a good match. 6,000 crowns would be the max one could achieve through accolades, although he remarks that it's nearly impossible someone would get all that. For these calculations, I'm going to assume that we have a 100% win rate, and they're all good performing games, so we'll go with the 2,500 crowns earned for each match. Bronze and silver do not cost any crowns to participate in, so these calculations for games played are pretty easy. 82,500 crowns divided by 2,500 crowns per match is 33 matches total to climb through bronze to silver. Similarly for silver, 165,000 divided by 2,500 equals out to 66 games, so about 100 total good performing games to get from bronze 10 to gold 10. For gold, we will need to factor in the cost in crowns for each match to be counted for leagues, so we'll subtract the cost of 250 crowns from the 2,500 crown assumption we made earlier. 385,000 divided by 2,250 equals out to just under 172 games to climb through gold and into platinum, so it jumps up quite a bit. Now for platinum, we'll figure out a range for the amount of games. You understand the math well enough at this point, so we'll just factor in 750 crown costs before each match, and that gives us a range of 378 to 472 games just to climb through platinum alone, so that's a pretty big jump there. Again, this is an assumed range of crowns you'll need to earn, so grain of salt, but also remember we're assuming every game is a good performing game, earning 2,500 crowns each match, and probably winning every single match. For diamond, the cost is 1,250 crowns per match, so that gives us a range of 792 to 1,320 games to climb through from diamond 10 to legend 10. So congrats on reaching the top rank, but if you can climb through legend through to the top of tier 1, then that range would be 1,375 to 2,750 games, which is insane. Again, guys, I cannot stress enough, for the later ranks of Platinum, Diamond, and Legend, these are assumed values, so big grain of salt. Now then, let's talk about time needed for each game. Maximum time for each Dominion match is 15 minutes, but our news article says that it's way more than enough time, so let's assume 12 minutes for each game, and we won't even factor in queue times either. Again, assuming 100% win rate in a good performance every match, and me rounding up to the nearest hour, it would take about 7 hours to climb through bronze, 14 hours to climb through silver, and about 35 hours to climb through gold. This is for each rank individually, by the way. Those are pretty solid numbers, all things considered, because we know for sure the maximum crowns for bronze, silver, and gold. Now, let's get into our speculation for Platinum, Diamond, and Legend. Platinum, I think, will take anywhere from 76 hours to 95 hours. Diamond would take about 159 hours to 264 hours. And if you want to climb to the top of Legend, assuming you can, that would probably take anywhere from 275 hours to 550 hours alone. Again, grain of salt, I don't know the total crowns needed to progress through each rank for certain, and this is assuming 100% win rate with good performance each match, 12 minutes per match, and no queue times. Now, for total time needed to grind from Bronze 10 to Legend 10, we would theoretically need to spend anywhere from 291 to 415 hours playing through leagues. If you wanted to grind all the way through to Legend 1, or the top of Legend 1 for that matter, that would take at least anywhere from 566 to 965 hours with the values we've assumed. It is a long time, to say the least. Now then, let's get into the important questions for me, because I have a day job, I am a content creator, and I like to enjoy my life here and there. So how much time would I need to play Spellbreak leagues per day to climb to Legend and beyond for Chapter 2? According to our numbers here, to climb all the way from Bronze 10 to Legend 10 within a 12-week chapter, so 84 days, we would need to play Spellbreak at least anywhere from 3.5 to 5 hours every single day with a 100% win rate and a good performing match every time I queue, even in Diamond, not including queue times and breaks. That is a long time every day, but those are weak numbers. How long would I need to play if I wanted to climb to the top of Legend 1 during Chapter 2? About 6¾ to 11.5 hours per day with our assumed numbers. Yeah, that's a lot of Spellbreak. Probably not gonna happen, Chief. Not for me. And I think I'll end the video there. Hope all these numbers entertained you as much as it did for me. I'm so tired of looking at numbers. And I hope we get some solid values for the total crowns we need for Platinum, Diamond, and Legend soon. That was insane. Also, how'd you like the small news announcement at the beginning? Are you excited for the release of Spellbreak Chapter 2 with the new Dominion mode in 2 weeks? What are you the most excited about? Let me know down in the comments. Also, be sure to like the video if you enjoyed my insane calculations, and subscribe if you'd like to see more content from me. I've got to go. I've been OSK. Y'all have a great day, and I'll see you all out there.